Hello students, in today's clinic I will tell you the procedure of impedance audiometry. Now this impedance audiometry is basically done to know the status of the middle ear. So usually prior to impedance audiometry we should do proton audiometry. If that proton audiometry is showing conductive hearing loss, then that is an indication for the impedance audiometry. So the common diseases for which we do the impedance audiometry are this otosclerosis and otitis media with effusion, and if there is any small central perforation of the tympanic membrane, if the patient is having grommet, to know the functions of the Eustache tube, if the patient is having acoustic neuroma. So these are some of the conditions in which we can do the impedance audiometry. So this impedance audiometry is an objective test. Proton audiometry, that was subjective test, means we need the cooperation of the patient. So we are dependent on the response of the patient. Whereas in impedance, it is totally objective test. It is fully automatic. I will show the machine also. It is fully automatic. But if you want to, and in this what we measure, actually we measure the reflected sound energy from the tympanic membrane. So this is a probe that is to be inserted into the patient's ear. It should be snugly fitted in the patient's ear, because if it is leaking, then the result will not come, rather the test will not start. So we should select this tip on proper tip so that it can occlude the external canal. And in this probe, there are three channels. One channel will produce the sound, that is oscillator. Another channel will pick up the reflected sound, that is the microphone is there. And the third channel will produce the various pressure in the external canal. So ideally, when the pressure of the external canal and the middle ear, if they are same, at that time patient hears best. So with this impedance audiometry we can know regarding the pressure of the middle ear, whether it is on the negative side or the positive side or the normal side, so that we can know, because pressure of middle ear and the external canal should be equal, and at that time we can hear the best, and that is called impedance audiometry, we call it the compliance. So we will be drawing a graph between the pressure changes and the compliance. So now I will request our audiologist and Dr. Sudhir Bhai to start the test. So while we are conducting the test, you should not move, you should not talk, and you should not swallow the saliva. So that means clinical cooperation will be needed. And you will feel this pressure changes, so don't get scared. So in the ear, you will feel little fullness and little vacuum you will feel, and the sound you will hear. So that is the part of the test. You come on this side so that you can pick up the, come on this side. So this is the headband. This is the headband. And you can see that we will be testing the right ear. But you can see this headphone that is on the left side. So for contralateral response, the sound will come from this side, and contraction of this cell that we will be recording. So it should be snugly fitted, there should not be any leakage. If there is leakage, the test will not start. Now right now we are testing the right ear again, color coding you can remember. This red, pink color it is for the right ear, and blue color it is for the left ear. So this was the tympanogram. Now it is taking the reflex, stepidus reflex, acoustic reflex. So in this 500 Hz, you can see that this reflex is appearing at the 80 decibel level. At 1 kHz, it is appearing at the 85. And the 2 kHz, it is appearing in the level of 90. So now we have done the audio. Now it is taking contra. Which contra means voice is coming from the opposite ear, from the left ear. And we are testing the, checking the reflex of the right ear. Again, you can see it is appearing in the, at the 500 Hz, it is appearing at the 0.02 level, 95 dB. So we have completed this complete test for the right ear. So then you can see this left ear test, that they are still remaining. So we'll change the probe from the left ear to, and from the right ear to left ear. Come on, this side. See, it will be covered. Can you see the probe? Yes, probe change kar diya isme. So they are changing the this probe from left to the right. So again, we have to remove the headband, because headband will, this headphone will come on the right side. So if the ear is exposed to the loud sound at that time, the tensor tympani and stapedius muscle, they contract. So contraction will occur of both the ears, both the sides. Even if the loud sound is coming to the left ear, right ear, and this contraction will occur in both the ears, right as well as left. So if you are measuring the same side, that we call ipsilateral acoustic reflex. And if you are measuring the opposite side, that is called contralateral. So the sound stimulus will come on the right ear, and it will take the contraction of the left ear. Again, we use, formally we have done did the right ear. You can see the color. And now we will test the left ear. Push kar left. Ear. Karo?
No,
sir. So again, you can see, first we will take the tympanogram, and then we will test the this reflexes. So he's again checking the probe whether it is fitted properly or not. Yeah. And now the test is beginning. So this pressure changes, that starts from 300 and that will go up to the minus 300. So at 80 Hertz, I will be showing you this impedance audiometry machine. This you can see, this knob, this is for the right ear, red color. This is for the left ear, blue color, that you can see. And this is for the tympanometry, tympanogram. And this is for the reflexes. I stand for ipsilateral and C stand for contralateral. As I told you, it is fully automatic test. So nothing else is done. We simply will have to insert the probe. So after inserting the probe, now this is left ear, let us say. First we will took the left ear. So this is the tympanogram of the left ear. Now on the x-axis you can see, this is the pressure, DAPA Pascal. And this is the compliance. On y-axis is the compliance, on x-axis, horizontal axis, the pressure changes. And now this peak, you can see that is showing us the maximum compliance in this particular case. So it lies in the normal range. And this sort of tympanogram is called tympanogram type A, that I will show you later on other types. So this is type A. So usually in the type A, the peak will lie at the neutral level, zero level, or it can lie up to the minus 150 level. So that is considered normal. So plus 50 to minus 150 pressure peak at that level, that is considered normal. Now this is showing you the left ear reflex, acoustic reflex. So we are feeding, we are presenting 80 dB, and if the response is not coming, then we will increase the this intensity 85, then we did the 90, then we did the 95, and then we did the 100. So at 100 you can say this reflex is coming for the 500 Hz. Then we tested for the 1 kHz. In 1 kHz it appeared at the 95 decibel level. If for 2 kHz you can see it's not appearing. So at the 2 kHz, in the left ear, this acoustic reflex is not present, it is absent. Now let us see on the right side, right ear. In the right ear, again, this is a tympanogram. Again, you can see this peak. Peak is occurring at the level of zero. On this side, it is plus. On this side, it is minus. So you can, as I told you, that this horizontal axis is showing you the pressure variation. So the pressure will sweep from plus 300 and it will go up to the minus 300. In some of the machines, it goes even up to minus 400 also. So in this, I think, Sudhir bhai, minus 400 sudhi jaye chhe, kya sudhi jaye chhe ma?
600
chhe sir. Ma 600, but usually minus 400 sudhi jato ho chhe. So, and again, this compliance is within the normal limit. So this is type A tympanogram. And regarding the reflexes, again, we can see at the 500 hertz, when we give the stimulus of 95, at that time it appeared. And it is showing you the compliance, 0.02. In the 1 kilohertz, it is appearing just at the level of 85 dB. 2 kilohertz, it is appearing at the level of 90 dB. So reflexes are present in both the cases. Yes, now I will show you some of the tympanograms and the reflexes, how we chart it and what paper, what report we give to the patient. So that I will show you now. Now this is the tympanometry report. So this is the tympanogram. Okay, now in this tympanogram you can see that at the vertical axis it's showing you the compliance, how much is the compliance. And on the horizontal axis, on the x-axis, is the pressure changes variation. This pressure changes variation that occurs from plus 300 and up to minus 600, you can see in this chart. And this sort of square is showing you the normal compliance. Means the peak of this compliance should be remain in this area. If it is above, then that is called high. And if it is below this, that is called low. That we will see in the other graphs also. And this is showing you the volume of the extranodic canal. And this is showing you the compliance. So we can measure also here. So in this case, this is the flat graph. You can see there is no wave in this. So this flat graph indicates that the patient is having otitis media with effusion. So with the flat graph, means no peak is there, nothing is there, it's a straight line. So in this situation, if the volume is normal, then we will say that the patient is having otitis media with effusion. Now, if the ear volume is more than the what is normal, it means there can be some perforation of the tympanic membrane. So if there is some perforation of the tympanic membrane, what will happen? So this machine will consider the area of external ear and the middle ear same. So in the volume, it will include even the volume of the middle ear. So if the volume is high, then the diagnosis should be in such case, the diagnosis will be tympanic membrane perforation. And if the volume of the external aortic canal is low and still it is giving the flat curve, it means ear wax is there. So in the cases of ear wax, ear canal volume will become less and the graph will be flat. So this is called graph B type. Okay, so A type already I have shown you, and again I will show you. And this is the left ear. So in this patient is having problem in both the ears, left ear as well as right ear. So left ear is showing you the type B graph, means flat line is there, you can see. Whereas on the right side, you can see this is peak is there, but this peak lies in the negative side. So in peak lies at the level of rather 250, that is abnormal. So in the C type, peak will be there, but that peak will compliance will be there normal, but the peak will come in the negative side. So that indicates the negative pressure in the middle ear, and that will lead to retracted tympanic membrane. So this graph is showing you that the patient is having retracted tympanic membrane and patient is developing otitis media with effusion. Now these are the acoustic reflexes. So in acoustic reflexes, what we do, we give the stimulus of begin from 80, and if the reflex is not coming, you can see in the increment of 5, this is the intensity of the sound that will be increased. And we are testing with 500 hertz, 1 kilohertz, 2 kilohertz. So these are the three frequencies on which we test the step in this acoustic reflex. So at the 500 hertz, you can see the reflex is coming on the 100 dB side. And at the 1 kilohertz, it is almost absent, it is not present. Because if the middle ear, if there is a fluid in the middle ear, actually in these patients, reflex will be absent. So there is no need to go for reflex test. We can even, if we do not do that, then also that's fine. So in this year also you can see that it is almost absent. Here it is showing you some height at the 100 dB little. But in the because as I told you, this flat graph indicates fluid. So the fluid is there. So you can see there's no stimulus, no reflex at any intensity or any frequency. So absent, all the reflexes, they are absent. So I showed you the type B graph that will appear as a flat line. Then I showed you the type C graph in which peak is there, but that is on the negative side. That indicates that in the beginning only I told you that when the pressure of external aortic canal and the middle ear is same, at that time compliance will be maximum. So here the pressure is negative in the middle ear, so even the external ear pressure also, that is negative, then it will be, it is giving you the peak. Now this tympanometry report is showing you the normal peak that you can see in this patient. That peak compliance maximum is at the level of 1.23. And you can see this area, shaded area. This is showing you that if the peak lies in this area, that is normal. So in this side, left ear is normal. And again, you can see this on this side is showing the pressure variation, and this vertical axis is showing you the compliance. But in the right ear, the pathology is there. You can see in the right ear, the peak is there at the normal zero, but it is going beyond this normal limit. So in this, the ear canal volume is 1.31 ml and compliance is 2.29. So this is abnormal. So this sort of graph indicates any discontinuity of the auscular chain. So if there is disruption of the auscular chain, then it will give rise to this type AD graph. This is called type AD graph because the depth is more. Okay. And even if the tympanic membrane is some cases, tympanic membrane is very thin, very lax. So in those cases also, this graph AD will come. So this is the normal side. So graph A, we will call it. And this is abnormal side. It is graph A, but there is type, another type, that is D. So it is D type, AD type graph. So in both this graph, in this graph again, you can see if the middle ear pathology is there, as I told you, usually the reflexes, they are absent. So here also reflexes, they are absent, but at this it is showing a little reflex, but it's not that significant. And this is the normal side. So normal side, you can see the reflex, they are present. So at the 2 kilohertz, when the intensity of the sound is 95, at that time they are appearing. Now this, yes. Now we are. So I am showing you the another this tympanometry report, and this tympanometry report is of patient who was having otosclerosis in both the ears. So you can see the peak here, but this peak, as I told you, it is not lying in this shaded portion. It is below that level. So this peak is this sort of graph will be called AS type. So A, there are three. A means that is total normal tympanogram. AS means it is shallow, and that appears and in the cases of otosclerosis. And otosclerosis, what happens? There is movement of this stapes bone that becomes restricted, it doesn't move at all. So that gives rise to fixity of this stapes bone. And there are other causes which can give rise to fixity of the auscular chain, like this stapedia malleus fixation. So if the auscular chain is fixed at any level, then this sort of graph will have. So this patient is showing you AS type graph in both the sides, right ear as well as left ear. And as I told you, in case in these middle ear pathologies, most of the time reflexes, they are absent. So here also you can see this is showing the reflex. So it is almost absent. At this it is showing a little bit, but it's not that significant. Here again it is showing, but it's not. So most of these frequencies and intensities, you can see there is no that wave. So reflexes, they are absent. Now this is normal tympanogram. You can see it is the speak is lying in the normal shaded area, that is showing you the normal range, but it is just at the borderline. Just below it, it will become abnormal, but it is simply touching, so that will include it in the normal. And here also you can see it is normal. It is at the zero. It is not on the negative side. If it is on the negative side, then the graph will become C type graph. And if it is flat, then it will become B type of graph that I showed you initially. Now in this case, you can see there is no pathology of the middle ear. So you can see the graph, this reflexes, they are present. So in case of otosclerosis, these reflexes, they will be absent. But in both sides, you can see the reflexes. They are appearing. Thank you.